You do not need that kind of
challenge in life here.
Well, I think we have Japan left, and we were there last year now, and in November, and we are very big in Japan now, so what remains really, in a big way, is the United States.
Yeah.
And we'll try that too.
Okay. Another question about Annika. Now she's leaving him. All the fellas listening want to know, has she got a boyfriend?
No, not really. It was not that. It was that they just found out that they didn't really, you know, it's to be married. It's a kind of, you share a life, and they found out that they didn't really want to do that.
Okay, fair comment, and especially living so closely, so long, it must really get on each other's nerves.
Yeah, I guess it is.
Anyway, we'd like to hear the new record. Tell us something about this. That means people
darling.
Is that what it means?
That's not like, what language is that?
Spanish.
Yeah, okay. And that is a song that we have given away, all income to UNICEF and the child of the year of the child.
That's right. I thought that was fantastic because you've given a good song. You know, some of them you just gave a whole catalogue of things. You gave a brand new record. I thought that was very generous.
Thank you, Andre. I mean, this is important to us, and I think that everybody should contribute to this UNICEF thing.
Okay, let's contribute on the air for a little bit now. Here's Chiquitita. Is that right? Chiquitita. Because, Stig, I want you to tell us about the new guy you found. We're just 12 minutes left after we've had a couple of bars of this. This is Radio Luxembourg. Tony Prince, live from the south of France.
They got the magic formula going for them there, Stig. It's an incredible success. Did you foresee it becoming as big as it is? I mean, it must have been after the Eurovision success that it really started happening. But did you ever in your life envisage that a Swedish outfit could become this phenomenal success they are?
No, of course not, because you are coming in from the cold.
Yeah.
And you've probably been taken to a madhouse if you have predicted something like that.
Especially a Swedish group, because it's very difficult to get Swedish music marketed around the world, isn't it?
Right.
Anyway, you're now having a relaunch for a new talent, I believe. You've found a new singer. Tell us something about him.
Yeah, his name is Ted. We call him Ted shortly in English. And he's 22 years old. He writes his own songs. This is his fifth album for us in Scandinavia. He's very big there.
And where's he from?
He's from Stockholm.
Yeah.
And I can only say that he has been very, very successful writing in Swedish. So we tried him, we said to him, we promised him to do something in English for him, and we went to Hollywood. And on the record, on the LP, you will find the best American musicians on that. And we decided to release a single here in Europe, including England, and that single is called Take Me Back to Hollywood.
Okay, let's listen to it right now. The man who discovered ABBA has now discovered Ted Gardstad, and you're the first listeners to ever hear him in Great Britain from Needham, the music festival of the world. From Cannes Live, this is Luxembourg.
I believe.
hey, Taxi-maker. Stig Anderson, have a nice week in Cannes.
Thank you very much, Tony.
And give our love to ABBA and wish them many more successes.
I certainly will.
Thank you very much. You're listening.